COVID-19 vaccines, many healthcare workers are still hesitant toward vaccine. More than one-fifth of healthcare workers globally are hesitant about receiving a COVID-19 vaccine. Researchers found that vaccine safety, efficacy, and potential side effects were the top reasons for concern, along with a host of misinformation about COVID-19 vaccines. Most people spend 8 waking hours in a full-time job. Beyond that, they are a part of the society for 16 hours. So, the time spent around family and community is more, and the influence could be greater from community and family norms, perceptions, and misinformation. This video brought to you by HealthyRN Ways channel that talks about the COVID-19 pandemic, video posting every Monday and Thursday. To see my other videos, see the link at the end card of this video. Healthcare worker vaccine hesitancy by the numbers. For the sake of the review, researchers considered participants hesitant if they declined or refused a COVID-19 vaccine, said they were unlikely to get one, or if indicated disagreement with vaccinating against the virus. Undecided participants were not counted. The researchers found that the prevalence of vaccine hesitancy worldwide ranged from about 4% to 72%, with an average of 22%. We have a misperception that healthcare workers practice better health behaviors and engage in healthier lifestyles. Looked at healthcare worker vaccine hesitancy globally, but the prevalence is potentially higher in the U.S. frontline healthcare workers were among the first groups of people in the nation to be offered a vaccine last December, with rollout beginning at the end of 2021. But not all jumped at the chance when their turn came. Factors that correlate with hesitancy. Researchers found three factors among healthcare workers that correlated with more hesitancy toward the COVID-19 vaccines: being female, having a lower education level, and being young. Gender-related findings were initially surprising to me, as I have always written that women practice better health behaviors. But the case of COVID vaccines is unique. In another preprint study, part of the COVID States Project, researchers surveyed more than 21,000 individuals across the U.S. about their COVID-19 vaccine attitudes. The researchers also found that vaccine resistance was higher in female healthcare workers than in males in the industry. For those surveyed in February 2021, 27% of female and 18% of male healthcare workers said they would not get a COVID-19 vaccine. Some women express concerns about vaccine side effects leaving them unable to care for their families or causing infertility. However, COVID-19 vaccine side effects tend to resolve within a few days, and experts have widely debunked concerns about the shots causing infertility. Education found a correlation between higher vaccine uptake among healthcare workers if they were doctoral degree holders or involved in patient-facing care. Those with lower education levels were more likely to be hesitant. Not all healthcare workers are doctors or have extensive training in medicine or research, and not all have waded through the vaccine data, which may be inaccessible to some people. Healthcare workers with lower levels of education may also be more vulnerable to misinformation on social media and elsewhere. Some participants expressed doubts on whether COVID-19 exists or didn't believe it is a serious disease. Others cited false conspiracy theories about the vaccines actually serving as an injection of microchips. For many people, it is a lack of knowledge that feeds into vaccine fear. The science behind these topics can be complex. The amount of information available, both true and false, is overwhelming. Healthcare workers around the world are not a monolithic group and have a variety of roles, types of training, and experiences in the eld. Those who are in patient care, know someone who died, or know infected or hospitalized clients are more likely to take the vaccine, as they understand the severity of the disease, have a higher perceived risk of getting infected, or perceive greater benefits of the vaccine. Age: younger healthcare workers were also more likely to be vaccine hesitant. The researchers attribute this finding to a few possibilities. Older healthcare workers may have higher education levels and more experience in the field, and age may impact a person's perceived vulnerability to a severe case of COVID-19. This aligns with a survey that found young people, in general, were more likely to reject the vaccines. Young respondents, individuals under 30, were more than twice as likely as older respondents to not want the vaccine. Unvaccinated healthcare workers pose a risk, Public health experts say COVID-19 vaccine hesitancy among healthcare workers poses a health threat to patients and the community at large. Healthcare workers regularly work with vulnerable populations and cannot rely solely on wearing masks or personal protective equipment to fulfill their professional obligations to their patients. An unvaccinated healthcare worker can unknowingly transmit SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19, to a patient or even cause an outbreak, as was the case at one Kentucky nursing home. The CDC confirms that an unvaccinated healthcare worker, who was offered a vaccine but turned it down, caused a COVID-19 outbreak in a skilled nursing facility that infected 26 residents, 18 of whom were fully vaccinated, and 20 staff members, 4 of whom were vaccinated. 3 residents died from the outbreak. The unvaccinated healthcare worker transmitted a more infectious variant of the virus. One unvaccinated person infecting everyone around in a healthcare setting can have a major financial and social impact, apart from the toll on health, well-being, and life. Experts also express concerns about how vaccine hesitancy among healthcare workers sways the general public opinion. Making serious medical decisions, like whether to get a new vaccine, is challenging for many people. When faced with this sort of decision, it makes sense to look to see what the people who are more knowledgeable regarding health sciences are doing and factor this information into decisions. Naturally, people look to those in healthcare to be their guides, whether intentional or not. Healthcare workers are serving as influencers for others' decision. For this reason, it is critical that healthcare workers support the drive to vaccinate the population against COVID-19, and that begins with overcoming their own hesitancy. If someone in your life is unsure about getting the COVID-19 vaccine, try having a calm and collected conversation with them about their concerns. Vaccine mandates for healthcare workers. Some hospitals are beginning to implement COVID-19 vaccine mandates for healthcare workers, with certain exceptions in place. Employees who refuse will be terminated from staff. Other hospitals may follow suit, especially if the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine receives full approval from FDA. All 3 vaccines are currently under emergency use authorization, but Pfizer is now under review for full approval. Legal experts are still trying to decipher what the EUA provision means for COVID-19 vaccine mandates. If a COVID-19 vaccine reaches full FDA approval, that means the agency vetted extensive research for the drug's safety, purity, potency, and effectiveness. And such a classification places a vaccine squarely in the camp of other FDA-approved inoculations. Currently, 15 states mandate measles, mumps, and rubella (MMR) vaccines for healthcare workers. And states have varying laws on healthcare worker flu shot requirements. Some experts champion education campaigns over COVID-19 vaccine mandates. Encourage, rather than command the person to examine the information provided and let the person decide ultimately what is best for them and their families. Nothing makes people shut down faster than being insulted or being forced. Once that happens, the battle lines are drawn, and instead of fighting together against the virus, we are now actively fighting each other. Expert says patients and others' lives are at stake. As long as we have the exemptions and freedom guaranteed by law, I see no harm in mandates and requirements. If an employee can be a risk to coworkers or clients, it is a prudent move to require them to get vaccinated. Black doctors and nurses are urging Black Americans to get COVID vaccine in a love letter to the Black community. A team of Black doctors and nurses is urging all Black people to get vaccinated against COVID-19. The Black Coalition Against COVID, BCAC, released the letter as one part of their plan to encourage the Black community to get vaccinated. Our colleagues across healthcare know that we are urging our community to take safe and effective vaccines once available. However, for this to be successful, they must do more to earn your trust, now and in the future. The Black Coalition Against COVID, the BCAC, is a cooperative of Black community leaders in healthcare, policy, and faith from the District of Columbia. They hope to encourage COVID vaccinations in Black Americans by providing trustworthy information from reputable Black doctors and leaders. At the beginning of the COVID-19 pandemic, the BCAC engaged with the Black Washington area religious community, organized labor leaders, academic institutions, medical leaders, and entertainers to carry important messages. As the organization began confronting COVID-19 vaccine hesitancy, they brought together the American Medical Association and Black Nurses Society. The BCAC then began to hold town halls that included members from the Department of Health and Human Services, HHS, the CDC, Anthony Fauci, and respected Black scientists. If you are going to fight a public health crisis, you have to have an engaged public. Our efforts have been well received, and are giving us encouragement that there is a hunger for trustworthy information coming from trustworthy sources. Why does vaccine hesitancy exist? At the root of most vaccine hesitancy lies distrust of the medical community. Historical examples such as the cases of Henrietta Lacks and the Tuskegee syphilis study, as well as more recent discrimination at the hands of the medical system, remain fresh in the minds of many Black people. Historically, there has been racism within the health system. Those stories and those feelings have been passed down from generation to generation. The older generations have clear memories of that, and we still see health inequities today, so there is a level of mistrust that we have to be honest about, we have to own, and we have to address. What this pandemic has taught me is that distrust is a disease itself and that disease leads to death. Other barriers to access include a lack of approachable information about the vaccines and difficulty accessing appointments. The nature of science is complex, the language is unfamiliar, and the science education in most high schools is inadequate. Some individuals may experience difficulties booking appointments online or lack transportation to vaccination sites. There was a suboptimal initial effort by the federal government to provide resources to the Black community. If you haven't yet been vaccinated against COVID-19, you can find an appointment near you. If you want to help encourage hesitant people in your life to get vaccinated, our COVID-19 Vaccine Healthy Conversation Coach can guide you through what to say, and what not to say, to someone expressing aversion toward the vaccines. How to rebuild trust. We are mounting a major effort between research and policy, and really focus on helping Americans of color to understand that you are reflected, your life matters, and we will work hard to be worthy of your trust. If we do not do this now, our response to the next crisis that occurs will also be suboptimal. The practitioner must be able to say to the patient, "I care about you and I respect you." The first step to rebuilding trust in scientific and medical institutions involves acknowledging the fears individuals may have and providing accurate, reliable facts addressing those concerns. People need to know that it's okay to have questions. They need to know that we are supportive of the risk-benefit ratio, and we respect that process. We can provide them with trustworthy information that can clear up any misperceptions they have and give them a factual basis on which to make that decision. Once people are more informed and their fears are addressed, then people are more likely to get the vaccine. Social media is a great place to get accurate information, but there is some information out there that is not valid. There's been a lot of unvalidated conspiracy theories that have been put out on the internet. The places and people who can administer the vaccines also make a difference. There are certain places that people within the Black community like to get their vaccines. Some may prefer to see their family doctor or primary care provider who they already trust. We need to get vaccines into family and primary care practices, which wasn't an option before. The federal and state governments are starting to recognize that you have to have providers the Black community trust. The importance of healthcare providers getting vaccinated themselves. Even Black providers who are on the front lines are shown less likely to get the vaccine than other groups, so share your story. People are more likely to get the vaccine if they know someone who has gotten it. Acknowledge that it's a selfless choice that you are making for your community, and we appreciate you for that. You are making our jobs easier by protecting everyone else. Get vaccinated now, the urgency for getting people vaccinated as soon as possible. These next 4 to 6 weeks are determinant, and we all have a responsibility to do everything in our power to win this war. The watch and wait policy are not a good one, because this is a race against time. If we want to have a normal Christmas and Thanksgiving this year, we all have to make some sacrifices now. More than one-fifth of healthcare workers globally are COVID-19 vaccine hesitant. And nearly half of frontline healthcare workers in the U.S. haven't received a COVID-19 vaccine. Younger, female healthcare workers with lower levels of education were more likely to be vaccine hesitancy. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. See you on my next video. Masalam 1.